Hi, this is Rob the Realtor, and in today's video, I'm going to be covering the rent versus buy analysis. Now, this is a video that I've wanted to do for some time now because in talking to people on the street, so many people say, I'm tired of paying my landlord's mortgage, and what do I need to do to purchase a home, and is that a good decision for myself and my partner? So today what I did is I looked at the multiple listing service in my hometown of Kelseyville, and I looked at what the average home price was, the average selling price, and the average size of the home. So the average sales price was $300,000, and for $300,000 you got on average a 1,600 square foot home. Now, according to our property managers here in Lake County, the average rents is roughly $1 per square foot. Obviously, area to area that can change. Over the hill in Sonoma County, Napa County, and the Bay Area, people would say a dollar a square foot, that's crazy. We can't even rent a closet here for a dollar a square foot. But anyway, here for this example, we're going to use my hometown of Kelseyville, $1,600 a month to rent a 1,600 square foot home in Kelseyville. So a lot of first-time home buyers, what they'll do to purchase a home is use an FHA loan. So with an FHA loan, you generally put 3.5% down for your down payment. So 3.5% of $300,000 is $10,500. Your monthly mortgage payment with your principal and interest is going to be $1,382 based on a 4% interest rate. Interest rates can vary depending on the way the market is, as well as your credit score, income, and monthly expenses. So this is based off of a 4% interest rate, $1,382 per month. Your homeowner's insurance would be roughly $100 a month or $1,200 a year. Property taxes, $288. And your mortgage insurance, which is required for any time you have a mortgage that is larger than 80% loan to value, you have mortgage insurance. So with only putting 3.5% down, you'd have a $277 per month mortgage insurance fee. So as you pay that mortgage down, you can refinance and get rid of that mortgage insurance when you get to a point where you have 20% equity in your home. But for this example, you'll be starting off paying around $277 a month for mortgage insurance for a total monthly payment of $2,035. Now you might look at that $2,035 compared to $1,600 a month and say, for an extra $435 a month, that would be worth it for me if I can own my own home. But there's better news now, because many of you know that you can deduct your mortgage interest from your taxes every year. So of that $1,382 principal and interest payment, $950 roughly is how much of that $1,382 goes towards interest, and then about $425 for principal in the beginning of your loan. The further you go through your loan process, the more every month you pay towards your principal and the less you pay in interest. But in the beginning, you're going to be paying $950 of that $1,382 just for interest. But you can deduct that from your income taxes. Now, if you, just to use round numbers, if your tax rate is 20%, you would be able to deduct $190 of tax savings every month from your that monthly payment. So if you take that off of the $2,035, you're really only paying $1,845 for that mortgage payment, or in order to, you know, be a homeowner. So $1,845 versus $1,600 a month. So for an extra $245, you can actually own your own home in Kelseyville based on this scenario, buying the average home. And in a lot of areas in Kelseyville, $300,000 would buy you a pretty nice home in the Rivieras and other areas like that. So one thing I did look up as well is the minimum credit score for an FHA loan, according to the internet, is 580, which is a pretty low credit score. I would say the average credit score most people have, a 650 or higher. So the higher your credit score, the lower your interest rate, and the lower your monthly payment's gonna be. But for a lot of people, they don't think they can qualify for a home because their credit's too low, and they might have a 600, a 625, a 650 credit score, and they can actually qualify for an FHA loan. So let's talk about some pros and cons for being, a renter versus a homeowner. So the pros for renting: if something breaks, like your air conditioner goes out, you need a new roof, things like that. You can call your landlord or property manager and they come in and fix it for you. The flexibility to move if you have a job change, you want to move closer to family, or whatever the situation might be. You can just give your landlord or property manager a 30-day notice and you can go ahead and move and just wash your hands of that home. Now, the cons is the restrictions. You can't paint the house, you can't, you know, put a deck on, you can't put a hot tub in, you can't do any of these things that you might want to do without the landlord's permission. So you're restricted in that sense. You're missing out on any potential equity gain if you're a renter. So last year in Lake County, on average, home prices went up around 20%. That varies from market to market around the lake. But let's just say, you know, your home went up 10%. If you bought it for $300,000, you just got $30,000 in equity gain in that 1 year alone, which in large part, you don't have to pay taxes on that. We can get into that in a different video with capital gains taxes, but that's tax-free money that you earn from that equity gain. If you're a renter, you don't get to participate in that. Now, again, like what I covered in the beginning of the video, you're paying somebody else's mortgage. So every time you're writing that check for $1,600 a month, that's just money that's gone and never coming back. If you're paying towards your own home, paying your mortgage down, that's actually going somewhere. So those are the pros and cons of renting versus buying. And as you can see, you might be surprised to see that it's not that big a difference to buy the average home in Kelseyville versus what you're paying in rent right now. When you take that mortgage interest deduction from your taxes, $245 difference every month. And most people can scrape up $245. So that's the video for today. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel, Rob the Realtor, and hit that notification bell, and you'll be notified anytime I come out with a new video. And if there is something real estate related that you want me to cover in a future video, please leave that in the comment section, and I'll be happy to make a video about that later on down the road. If you are looking to see if you qualify for a loan, contact your mortgage professional or get a hold of me and I can refer you to a good mortgage broker. This is Rob the Realtor signing off, and we'll see you soon.